Welcome to the longest journey. The first thing I'm going to do, though, is we're going to mess the settings, because it is very loud.
Hello? Testing. One. Hello? Testing. Testing. Hello? Testing. Hello? Testing. One.
I do kind
one,
of want you to be
two.
Able to... Wow, loud. I do kind of want you to be able to hear the everything. Unfortunately, yeah, that seems about right. Okay, so I want time skip, shadow, special. Yeah, okay, we're good. So, welcome to the longest journey. Before I get started, before we start playing this game, this is going to be a long journey, just as a warning and a spoiler. I'm playing this without notes today, just because I want to show you the game a little bit before we actually dive in and get playing. The Longest Journey is a game that I really, really love, and I'm going to have a hard time playing this because of the way it's set up. So, I'm going to append videos into this series, which is going to make it probably look a little bit weird because the videos will be lower quality than the actual game. That's the one thing. The second thing you need to be aware of is that there are adult themes in this game before we even get going. You need to know that. If you have at all a sensitive stomach about things like swearing or like adult themes in general, relationships, that kind of thing, my suggestion is maybe don't watch this one, but you won't be watching something for a while because this is a long game. Having said that, Longest Journey is a beautiful, beautiful game. The only reason I don't recommend it quite so highly as I might is because I'm not a fan of the protagonist. And I'll explain that when we get to the protagonist herself. But the game itself is wonderful. The world it's set in is wonderful. And it kicked off a very interesting saga. So that's the Longest Journey in a nutshell. We're going to start playing. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to let the intro run. There's a lot of text in this game. Let the intro run. And then we'll start playing. I shall see you at the end of the intro. Here we go, folks.
So, you've come to hear me tell a story, have you?
If you please, we would love to hear one of your stories. You have seen so much. You have lived so long.
Oh, so good of you to remind me of my age, child. No, don't worry. I am an old woman, but I've lived a long and fulfilling life, and I do have stories to tell. Which story would you like to hear?
A true one. A true story.
All my stories are true, child. There are enough fairy tales in the worlds already. There's no need for me to make up more, believe me.
Tell us the story of the balance, then.
You want the story of the balance? Oh, that's a long story, child, and not one I'd venture to tell at this hour. But perhaps I could tell you a story that I heard a long time ago. A story that became a crucial turning point in the history of the balance, and that set in motion wheels that to this day are still turning.
Please, yes, that does sound like a story we'd like to hear.
Very well. This story, like all good stories, begins where it ends, in a tower, in a realm that is no more.
Thank you. Oh, no. Don't tell me I'm dreaming again.
You know, for once, just once, it would be nice to have a decent night's sleep without waking up screaming from a bad dream at 4 a.m.
Welcome to the longest journey. Right, so we're here and it is now. This is our protagonist, and no, she isn't wearing a lot of clothes, I'm aware, don't worry. The way it works is it's pretty simple. If you can see, like, there, it says landscape. If you can click on it,
left-click will pretty.
Generally tell you about something. Up here, we've got the options, the quit, and inventory. We have nothing in our inventory, but we will eventually. So, if you do this, you walk. Generally, if you see something...
What's happening? Oh, perfect. I guess if I don't do something to save that egg, I'll suffer 7 years of bad karma or something.
My recollection of that is that I can hear sound, so it's a little weird that I can't. You can look at... So the interface is pretty simple. If you can click on something, you can generally look at or you can take. So if you look at it...
It looks reptilian, but it can't be. It's much, much too big and... I don't much care for reptiles.
You can try and take the egg.
Did that sound come from the egg? Boy, that's some chick.
Okay, I don't think we're hearing sounds properly.
I don't think I can get a good grip on it. It's too big and slippery and I might drop it by accident.
So I'm going to try and very quickly fix that. Where's my game settings? Sound effects. Let's see if we can hear the egg now. Ah, that's better. I can hear sounds now. So, over here we have a nest. And if we walk around a little bit, we can see that there's an old tree. If we go a little bit more this way, we will see that there's a stream and a twig. Now the thing about the longest journey, and the thing that's maybe a little awkward about this game, is that this has got different viewpoints, and sometimes it's a little difficult to tell when you're going to go to another different viewpoint. So if you just walk along like this, you'll go plop, and you're in a different viewpoint. There's a stream there. Let's go grab the twig.
It's as dry as a bone. It'd probably snap right off in a second.
Grabbing the twig.
Oh, the suffering we must endure.
What?
Why do you take such pleasure in torturing us?
Torturing you? Who are you?
We are the voice of all trees, the spirit of wood and leaf.
You're a talking tree?
No, a tree does not talk. At least not in your tongue. The tongue of trees is the language of wood, root, and leaf.
Who are you then?
Like we said, we are the voice of all trees. Whenever an injustice is done, we must speak for the tree if we are present.
It's the branch. I shouldn't have broken the branch off.
Oh, what does it matter anyway? There is nothing more to be done for us. We are simply here to provide comfort in the final passing to Earth.
We? I only see one of you.
We are one with our host, as we are all one spirit, but legion.
Yeah, thanks for clearing that up.
We do not expect you to understand. You are human.
Okay, so here we have these choices, and you can use the mouse or the keyboard. What happened to the tree? What's the deal with the egg? Who are you again? And you can ask all of these things. These are like Monkey Island conversation starters. Let's talk about who are you again.
Who are you again?
We are the wood spirit. We come to all trees in the hour of great need to provide comfort and aid in the passing to Earth and to give a voice to those who suffer.
be prepared for people in this game to be pseudo-mystical. There's a lot of that in this game. What's the deal with the egg?
What's the deal with the egg?
Egg? What egg? Oh, of course, the child. Whenever the mother was absent, we were entrusted with the safety of the child. But now, withered and without strength, we can do nothing to help. We have failed the mother, and we despair. Our shame knows no bounds.
What happened to the tree?
Oh, the pain. As the battle raged, we...
Battle?
Between the mother and Black Chaos. She was only protecting her child, but it would not back down. And the force of their battle shook the mountain. The brook that fed us was led astray, and without water, we began to wither and die. Our time is running out as we speak. The passing to Earth is about to begin. Leave us now.
What about the egg?
Oh, it is too late. Without sustenance, we do not have the strength to bring it safely home. We have failed. And the Earth will know our shame for all time to come.
Okay, so there's two choices here. Isn't there something I can do to help? Are you always this glum?
Are you always this glum?
We are here because it is too late. The passing has begun. Leave us, please.
Isn't there anything I can do to help?
Oh, we do not expect a human to come to our aid.
Lose the attitude, okay? Just tell me if there's anything I can do.
It is futile. We need water, but there is none. Not after the brook changed course.
I'll find a way. Don't panic.
We do not panic. Unlike you, we accept our destiny. If, however, against all odds, you do succeed, we will carry the child safely back into its nest. Do not make a foolish attempt on your own. It would spell certain misery.
So one good thing about this game is that when you have one conversation starter left, it will automatically ask that question. I'll generally go from the things I think are least important to the things that are most important. So what we heard there was, if we fix the tree, it will, and you can see here there's a nest over there, it will take the child back to the nest. So let's look at the nest.
It's a nest, padded with large scales. Very large scales. For some strange reason, I have a feeling I should get the hell out of here before the tenants return.
Okay, so the other thing that you can do, of course, is you can try and do something to the nest.
This is interesting. I've never seen a scale this size before.
And you take the scale.
I'll keep it as a souvenir.
So, her inventory works this way. If you go to the top, you've got the branch, you've got the scale, and you can work with them by looking.
It's the withered limb of a dying tree. I feel so guilty. I really do. It's a large, slick, and somehow disturbingly reptilian scale.
You can also work with them.
I think I just made a funnel. Cool! I'm so proud of myself.
Oh dear. Anyway. One of the things that you can do is take things into the world. Now, at the moment, we can't do anything with this funnel because we're in the wrong place. But if we go to somewhere where the funnel will work, like, yeah, oh wait, hang on, April, don't go that way. If you have the funnel here, and you go out of the inventory, and you see something that the funnel could work on, like the egg, you could try it on the egg. Oh, you can't, evidently. Okay, all right. You'll see there, this is to the stream. And now we've got the stream
fresh
over here.
Water. Back in the real world, they'd probably charge $15 a bottle for this.
Yeah, that is a little crazy. But if you've got something in inventory and you can use it, it will glow like this, like it did for you combining the items. So if we click here...
This should do the trick.
This is an amazing cutscene, by the way. So we're done with that. And if you now talk to the old tree, because you can't now that talk icon has shown up.
Hello? Hello?
Leave us be.
Are you okay?
We find our strength returned, and so we have no time for idle conversation. We must drink and rejoice.
Aren't we forgetting something?
Hush, listen. The song of ancient wood. Is it not sweet?
Sweet, definitely. Yeah. The baby's probably ready to boogie down as well.
The baby? Oh, the egg. Thank the earth. We almost forgot.
Uh-oh. What? What was that? Uh-oh.
It is you. You have come.
You know me?
April, daughter, I have been waiting for you.
Waiting? Why?
Because it begins here, with you, as it always has.
What do you mean?
The breach and the mending, the pain and the joy, the end of the old and the dawn of the new. A different world. I am the mother of what is. But you, you are the mother of a future that may yet be.
How will I know? How will I know what to do?
I will guide you, and I will protect you as much as I can. But in the end, you are on your own.
I'm afraid.
You always were, my child, my daughter.
This is probably not a good thing. I must have been tossing and turning all night. So hot in here, too. No wonder I keep having these weird dreams. I've basically been simmering in my own sweat every night this past week. Doesn't look like it's gonna cool down anytime soon, either. It's another sunny day in Newport.
Okay. So... Oh, right, sorry.
Well,
she's not done.
It's a good thing the studio's got proper air conditioning. I promised myself I was going to spend most of the day working, and I don't intend to break that promise. Not this time.
So, the next thing that you need to be aware of is that in the longest journey, if you double-click somewhere, you can run. That's very important. So we're going to go to a closet, because we want to get dressed. That's important. And we got some clothes, we've also got a suitcase, we've got some drawings, and we've got the toy monkey. We'll...
Alright, so my wardrobe's sort of chic deficient, but I can't afford to be cutting edge. Useful, practical, and cheap is my shopping mantra. I could only carry one suitcase with me when I left home. There was so much I would have loved to bring, but c'est la vie. At least it was a clean break with my past. I guess when all my hard work starts paying off, I'll get a house and fill it with all kinds of new junk. The past, who needs it? It's a bunch of drawings I drew when I was a kid. I don't even know why I brought them here. They mean absolutely nothing to me.
meet the toy monkey.
It's Constable Guybrush, my toy mon... Oh, ape. He doesn't much like being called monkey.
And we can pick him up. He makes the most annoying sound, though, so just be warned. Okay. We got two things in here. You got your cash card. That's going to be useful throughout the adventure. And we got the toy monkey. You can wind him up, but like I say, he makes the most annoying noise ever.
Constable Guybrush is a strange hybrid between man, ape, and musician. In addition to being an officer of the law, of course.
I'll let you hear the sound, but it's truly... And also, he is nightmare fuel. Good lord. This is what he sounds like.
Hey! You! Yeah, you! Hands up! Spread your legs! And do the monkey!
Mildly amusing, but irritating as hell.
There we go.
I think I'll shut him up now.
Right. So, if you click on him, you can use him in the world, of course. So, we need to get out of here. And... Next thing we need to do is look at the window.
Nice view, if you're into brickwork.
And now you can look outside. This is important. This is the worst puzzle in the game, by far. This guy here, we'll be dealing with him later, but not quite now. Anyway, we need the diary.
My on-again, off-again diary. We've had a turbulent relationship, her and I.
Okay.
I'm part of the should-be-reading-more-but-life's-too-short generation. We embrace our illiteracy. The last book I read was How to Seduce the Man of Your Dreams. Now, if I can just find a man to dream about, I'll be all set. That's my work. It's supposed to be a portrait of my life study teacher, but I think he might disagree. That fan is supposed to keep the room nice and cool in the summer. Sure, yeah, it's at least, one quarter of a degree cooler in here when it's on.
Okay, we got a new inventory item. I'm gonna look at the diary in the next episode, but the picture is sort of important.
It's a picture of Charlie, Emma, and me in Florence Park. Marcus took it about a month ago before it got real hot.
Remember those names, they're gonna crop up again. And this is your
desk.
That's
my desk, so theoretically, that's where I'm supposed to do my work. I think my muse has departed me for greener pastures, though, because lately, inspiration's been fleeting at best. Shelves.
There's also the plant.
I'm not good at taking care of living things, but this plant's doing just fine despite months of neglect. I don't need to make my bed. It's been too hot to sleep with a cover. I had to borrow some posters from the cafe because I just can't afford to buy any of my own. When I think about it, that's so depressing.
That is so depressing. Anyway, in the next episode, because I'm going to end the episode here, we're going to walk outside of the apartment and go and see what there is to see. Welcome to Longest Journey, Gorks. I hope you enjoy it because I'm going to enjoy playing it with you. I will see you in the next episode. Have a great evening, and I'll see you in 2 days, folks. Goodbye.